Welcome to the Eye of Truth. Parallel universes, the spiritual world, the realm of the mind, the afterlife. These phrases and concepts have existed since long ago and among all peoples of the world. Thousands of years before the development of modern science, people once believed deeply in these concepts. However, science has made rapid progress over the last 100 years, and concepts such as the afterlife and the spiritual world are now seen as belonging to the world of movies and cartoons. If someone now speaks seriously of the existence of parallel universes or the spiritual world, it can sound pretty wild. In this video, I'll be covering this wild topic. Why? Although the existence of parallel universes seems completely incompatible with modern science, some recent research has suggested that these worlds might actually exist. I'm especially interested in this topic myself. Be sure to stay with me until the end. As indicated by the title of the video, the existence of parallel universes is deeply connected with the mathematical concept of imaginary numbers. Therefore, I'll start by covering imaginary numbers. An imaginary number is a type of number represented by the letter I. Unlike physical numbers, such as 0 through 9, imaginary number I is a number created by mathematicians. Imaginary number I is defined as a number which, when squared, will become negative 1. However, squaring any number other than 0 will always result in a positive number. You probably remember being taught this in school. Therefore, an imaginary number or its concept represents logic that doesn't exist in reality. As the name suggests, an imaginary number is imaginary or not real. Similarly, we also created the concept of negative numbers. However, we do use negative numbers every day, for example, to represent debt or liabilities. So the concept of negative numbers is easier to understand than imaginary numbers. So, if squaring a number will never result in negative 1 in the real world, why did we create imaginary numbers in the first place? At this point of the video, you might recall studying imaginary numbers back in high school and wondering the same thing. Actually, the introduction of imaginary numbers has made many complicated mathematical calculations simpler, allowing us to derive results more quickly. Imaginary numbers have therefore become a crucial tool in the field of mathematics. For certain applications, this can be a powerful and convenient tool, and many fields in the study of physics make use of imaginary numbers to perform calculations. However, unlike mathematics, physics is a discipline concerned with researching the actual world. Therefore, these imaginary numbers are used merely as a tool for calculation and are generally understood to not carry any physical meaning themselves. However, something strange and unbelievable occurred after the discovery of quantum mechanics. I've mentioned this several times in other videos. Photons, electrons, and other tiny particles that exist at the microscale level studied in quantum mechanics are unlike things that exist in our regular world, in that they exist in several different states at the same time. In order to represent the behavior of particles that maintain such a state, Erwin Schrödinger, who devised the famous thought experiment of Schrödinger's cat, proposed the Schrödinger equation. This equation is capable of predicting the behavior state of a particle and is the most fundamental equation in the field of quantum mechanics. Strangely, this equation, which expresses the state of a particle that exists in the real world, contains an imaginary number, which of course does not exist in the real world. This imaginary number appears here because it came out naturally as the equation was being derived. This is fine for mathematics, but for physics presents a problem. Due to this imaginary number, the wave function that expresses the state of a particle becomes a complex number. A complex number is a number that half exists in the real world, with the other half formed by an imaginary number that does not exist in the real world. This is strange. Why? Mass, speed, temperature, and other physical quantities used to express the reality or state of an object are all real numbers. However, a wave function used to express a quantum state is not a real number, but a complex number. Physicists of the time didn't understand why. However, in the field of mathematics, this equation is not a problem at all. In fact, results obtained using this equation match observations. Even Schrödinger, who proposed the equation, wanted to eliminate imaginary number I from the equation, since the equation is meant to depict the real world. He worked for an entire year to derive an equation free of imaginary numbers, and while he thought he could get the same results using the new equation, it was far more complicated. Schrödinger ultimately returned to his original equation containing an imaginary number. However, we are left with some major questions. In quantum mechanics, are imaginary numbers, which don't exist in the real world, simply mathematical tools? Do we really need to use imaginary numbers to represent the world of quantum mechanics? Although these questions had no definite answers for around 100 years since the discovery of quantum mechanics, some recent research has finally provided what seems to be definite answers. In January 2022, two papers were published in an academic journal called Physical Review Letters. Two research teams used completely different scientific methods to arrive at the same conclusion. Based on the results of their highly precise experiments, the research teams concluded that imaginary numbers were crucial for quantum mechanics and were required in order to completely represent the world of quantum mechanics. This means that the microscale world studied in quantum mechanics, in other words, the particles that are the basic elements making up our real world, have some kind of fundamental relationship with imaginary numbers. However, I mentioned at the start of the video that the concept of imaginary numbers was created by us. Why is the concept of imaginary numbers an important part of the most basic elements making up our real world? One possible answer is that imaginary numbers do exist in this world. Imaginary numbers carry some physical meaning. What physical meaning could these numbers carry? This will be the topic of future research for sure, but I'll offer my theory here. My theory goes like this. Imaginary numbers are part of the realm of consciousness that makes up a part of our world. By realm of consciousness, I refer to the same concept as a parallel universe, the spiritual world, or the afterlife. The world in which we live is made up from real numbers, that is, normal numbers. In contrast, there are other worlds made up from only imaginary numbers. Existing in this world of imaginary numbers is what we call consciousness. The physical world composed of real numbers, and the realm of consciousness composed of imaginary numbers, exist superimposed. The fact that a wave function depicting the behavior of a particle in quantum mechanics is a complex number, and many other strange phenomena that occur in quantum mechanics, can be explained by the existence of this world of imaginary numbers or the realm of consciousness. For example, there is a curious phenomenon in quantum mechanics called quantum entanglement. Quantum entanglement is where one electron, through some means or another, is split into two. Then, each fragment flies off toward a different location. No matter how far these two fragments travel away from each other, both fragments retain information indicating they were once the same thing, and so they always share the same state. For example, imagine that the two fragments fly off to two separate labs. A researcher at Lab A observes his fragment and notices that it is rotating counterclockwise. At that very moment, a researcher at Lab B would notice that her fragment is rotating clockwise. The states are shared much like both sides of a coin. By observing the state of one fragment, the shared state of the other fragment is also confirmed. Further, even if the two fragments grow 100 or even 10,000 light-years apart, their states will be shared instantaneously. Transmitting information above the speed of light seems at first to clearly contradict the theory of relativity, and, up until the point that quantum entanglement was verified experimentally, even Einstein himself believed quantum entanglement to violate the laws of physics. Although the mechanism behind this phenomenon is still not clearly understood, the existence of parallel universes made up of imaginary numbers could help explain why quantum entanglement occurs. That is, when something is observed here, consciousness, which exists in the world of imaginary numbers, begins to function. In that world, speed, time, and space pose no limits. Assume that there are two electron fragments located far away from one another in the world of real numbers. In the world of imaginary numbers, there is no concept of distance, and so each of these fragments would continue to exist as the single electron they were prior to splitting. Therefore, even if the fragments were separated by 100 or even 10,000 light years in the world of real numbers, they would be able, through the world of imaginary numbers, to share their state instantaneously. This theory might sound bizarre, but it could explain why consciousness can have an effect on the physical world. So, if this world of imaginary numbers truly exists, what if we could enter it? What could we do, and how might it change us? What follows is just my conjecture. The first thing that comes to mind would be space telecommunications. We currently use electromagnetic waves for communication. Imagine that we discover intelligent life on a planet located 10 light years away. If we sent a message to them from Earth, it would take 10 years for it to reach them, and then another 10 years for their reply to reach us. Hardly an effective means of communication. However, if we could enter the world of imaginary numbers, where there are no limits on speed or time, we could send messages instantaneously, even to recipients 10 or even 10,000 light years away. Of course, we could also use this on Earth to maintain stable communication without any delay. Let's take it a step further. We could use the world of imaginary numbers to travel through space. Of course, we would not be sending our physical bodies through space, but instead would be sending our consciousness into the world of imaginary numbers to travel through space. Consider black holes, which are inescapable once entered. We could send our consciousness into a black hole, travel freely within it, and return safely. Future developments might even allow us to live completely in the world of imaginary numbers. Once we can accomplish this, we would become a Type 4 civilization, which I discussed in my video about alien civilizations. We would then be able to separate our consciousness from our physical selves and achieve immortality, travel freely through space, and even enter worlds in higher dimensions. In the movie Interstellar, the hero is sent into the fifth dimension by an advanced civilization. I believe that this civilization is a Type 4 or higher civilization existing in the world of imaginary numbers. The fact that we cannot seem to discover extraterrestrial life could be explained as a result of all extraterrestrial intelligent life having already entered the world of imaginary numbers. Although the topic covered in this video may seem like something taken from a sci-fi story, if we can solve the many mysteries of quantum mechanics, these theories may be proven true someday. Although this probably won't occur in our lifetimes, at the very least, I do expect the existence of this key to the realm of consciousness to be scientifically proven within the near future. Thank you for watching.